Peter, Edmund, Susan, Lucy, quickly to the shelter. The planes will be overhead any minute now.
Lucy, come on.
Coming.
Wait, Dad.
Edmund!
No, what are you thinking? Come on now.
Come on, Edmund. Why can't you ever just do what you're told?
Attention, children, be sure to wear your identification badges at all times. You will not be allowed to board the train without your badges.
Do you have your badge, Lucy?
Yes, Peter.
You know, I don't see why we have to go to the country. You know, Dad wouldn't make us go to the country.
Edmund, don't be stupid. If Dad were here, the war would be over and we won't even have to go.
Are your ration cards?
Remember, look after each other. Stay here and wait for the conductor. Hi, my darlings.
Come on. We have to stay together. Everything is going to be okay.
I know how to get on a train.
Tickets and badges, please.
Hey, put out that light. Don't you know there's a war going on?
I'm just trying to show the kids their seats on the train.
That does not affect the blackout. If Hitler were to see that torch, it would bomb us all to bits.
Now, don't you scare the children.
We're not afraid of Hitler, sir.
Good for you, lad. Your names?
Peter.
Edmund.
Susan.
Lucy. Our second name is Pendency.
In you hop now. Your train is ready.
The light, mind you.
Good luck, kids.
Must be the evacuees.
We are the Pendencies, madam.
Well, come along, children. Children, come along. Yes, it's all very nice. Now, come along, children. Come along, children, let's go. Ration books, please. Ration books, please.
Thank you.
One, two, three, four. Well, I suppose we'll find room for you somewhere.
Of course we will. We'll find two of the most exquisite rooms in the manor. I'm Professor Kirk, and this is my home. And behold, this is my housekeeper, Mrs. MacCready. I find it wise to obey her in most things. And these young ladies are our chambermaids. Ivy.
How do you do?
And Margaret.
Welcome, children.
We all hope your stay here will be happy.
And exciting! Now, let's introduce you to the staff.
Thank you, sir.
I'm Edmund.
Edmund? Sir, you idiot.
Edmund, sir, you idiot.
I'll remember you, Edmund. Then you must be Peter. Good. And you, Peter, are older than your sister, Susan.
Yes, sir. By a year.
Which puts you in charge.
Well, actually, sir, our father says we must each try to share responsibility according to our own aptitudes, which means we are all in charge.
I see. I think. Susan, isn't it?
Oh, yes, sir. How do you do?
Very well, thank you. And you must be Lucy.
Professor.
How do you do, Lucy? Now, Mrs. McCready, would you care to run through the list, the very short list, of house rules for the benefit of Peter, Susan, Edmund, and Lucy?
I would indeed, Professor. Right, children. Meals will be served at 8 o'clock, 1 o'clock, and 7 o'clock precisely. Be prompt and clean if you wish to be fed.
Be prompt and clean!
Shh, Edmund!
You may watch television in the library only when the professor is not working. Bedtime is at 9 p.m., lights out at 9:30. Do not let me catch you out of bed after lights out. No talking or playing of silly games after bedtime.
But when can we play our games?
As I have already stated clearly enough, and I don't like to repeat myself, especially to children. Not when there are visitors in the house, not when the professor is working, and not before breakfast. Have I made myself clear now, boy?
Actually, no, not really. Ah, yes, yes, yes. Thank you, Mrs. McDougal.
McCready!
McCready.
Thank you, Mrs. McCready. Take a look around. I'm sure you will find plenty of things to do, plenty of places to explore. Oh, and don't forget to visit the green room upstairs. There are all manner of friendly characters dressed for battle up there. Enjoy your first day at Finchley Manor. Ivy and the girls will help you carry your things.
It's lovely to have you children stay with us, but you must be mindful of Mrs. McCready. She can be very sharp, but her bark is worse than her bite.
The poor dear is just under a lot of stress because of the war. To raise money, the professor has allowed for busloads of tourists to come for guided tours of Finchley, but poor Miss McCready must lead them around.
It makes her quite nervous. Just whatever you four do, stay out of sight when the tourists come through. She'll be very nasty if you interrupt one of her tours. You understand.
We'll take your bags to your rooms.
Enjoy your first day.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
McCready seems like a real witch to me.
You're going to get us all thrown out, you ill-behaved monster.
You know, you can be a very nasty boy sometimes, Edmund.
Oh, come off of it. She deserved it. The professor's a silly old man, and McCready's a horror. And as for you, Lucy...
Yes, Professor!
Such a suck-up.
Will you just leave her alone, Edmund?
You know what? Get lost. I'm going exploring. So there.
You can't. You're going to get us all in trouble.
Who cares?
Well, aren't you going to do anything about him?
Why should I?
Well, for one thing, Peter, someone around here has to start acting responsible. What was that?
It was only an owl. I bet this place is fabulous for birds and animals. I bet there are stags, eagles, hawks,
badgers, foxes, rabbits, squirrels, fawns, weasels.
I'm going exploring in the morning.
There you are, Peter. You will never believe what Edmund has done. He's already started exploring, and he's miles away by now, too. We have to go after him.
You're right. Come on then, Susan. You stay here, Lucy.
Oh, please don't leave me here all alone.
Lucy, you'll be fine. We're only going to be gone a minute. Oh, that little monster.
They're rotten. Fancy leaving me here on my own.
What was that?
It sounded like somebody treading on a cat.
That really is the most enormous wardrobe.
Perhaps I should do some exploring. How strange. A cold breeze and it's filled with fur coats. Why, somebody spilled sugar on the floor. It's all crunchy. It's so dark.
No! There's a light! What's that on my face?
feels like tree branches. There's a lamppost. Whoever heard of a lamppost inside a wardrobe?
Good evening. Excuse me. I don't mean to be inquisitive, but should I be right in thinking that you are a daughter of Eve?
My name's Lucy.
Oh, but you are a girl?
Of course I'm a girl.
Oh my, you are in fact human.
Of course.
Oh, delighted. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Tumnus.
Pleased to meet you, Tumnus.
Oh, and Lucy, oh, daughter of Eve. How have you come into Narnia?
Narnia? What's that?
Oh, you've come from the wild woods of the West.
Oh, I came through the wardrobe in the spare room. But it's quite different there. Back there, it's summertime.
Oh, it's midwinter here in Narnia. It's been winter for ever so long. But won't you come and take tea with me?
Oh, thank you, Tumnus, but I ought to be getting back.
Oh, but it's just around the corner. There'll be a roaring fire, sardines, toast. There'll be cake.
Well, I can't stay for very long.
Oh, take my arm, daughter of Eve. I'll hold my umbrella over both of us. Come on now. Oh, you see this tree here? I'm friends with this tree. His name's Sam. He's my best friend. This tree... not so much. Oh, hold on. Oh, here we are. Home, sweet home. You can take a seat while I prepare the tea things. Ooh. Here's some tea. Some bread. Oh, here we go.
Oh, that'll do. What's it like, Tumnus, living in a forest in Narnia?
Oh, the forests in Narnia, they can be harsh. But we find a way. Oh, we had the most glorious summers once, and it was endless with fields of fruits and flowers. Ooh.
What a lovely sound. I must have fell asleep. It was such a lovely tune, but...
Oh, but it's no good now, you see.
No good. I've got to be going at once. The others will be wondering where I've gone. Tumnus, whatever's the matter? Tumnus, you ought to be ashamed of yourself, a great big fawn like you.
Oh, I don't suppose there's been a worse fawn since the beginning of the world.
What have you done?
I'm in the pay of the White Witch.
The White Witch? Who is she?
Well, she's the one who keeps all of Narnia under her crooked thumb. She's the one who makes it always winter.
How awful, but what does she pay you for?
I'm paid to be a napper? No, kidnapper. Would you believe that I'm the sort of fawn to meet a poor innocent child in the woods and invite it back to my cave and give it tea, and all the while been waiting to go and tell her?
But you wouldn't do anything of a sort.
Oh, but I have.
Well, that's pretty bad, but I'm sure that you'll never do it again.
Oh, Lucy, sweet child. Don't you understand? It's not something that I have done, it's something I am doing now.
What do you mean?
Well, the White Witch told me that if I ever met any human children, I was supposed to get them for her. And, well, you're the first one I met, so I pretended to be your friend, and I gave you tea, and I've been waiting to go and tell her.
But you won't, Tumnus, will you?
Oh, if I don't, she'll be sure to find out. Just one wave of her wand, and I'll be a stone statue of a faun until the four thrones of Caer Paravelde are filled, if that time ever comes.
I've never met anybody so utterly stupid in my life. Trying to climb inside a suit of armor in the dark.
It was a joke. I was trying to hide.
Oh, ha ha ha.
I was gonna make you all jump.
Well, you certainly frightened the poor cat who was living inside the armor, didn't you?
And did you even think for a moment about all the noise you were making?
Of course you didn't.
And anyway, I've cut my finger.
Oh, Edmund.
It's not even that bad. It's all right! I'm safe! I'm back! No need to worry!
What on earth are you talking about, Lucy?
Haven't you all been wondering where I've gone?
No.
But I've been gone for ages and ages.
Nutcase! With fruit!
Shut up, Edmund. Lucy, what are you talking about? Exactly what I said. When you were off looking for Edmund, I went exploring in the wardrobe. And that was last night because I had tea and everything.
Now, Lucy, I think you're really being silly. You see, Peter and I were just out in that corridor, and we found Edmund trying to climb into a suit of armor like an idiot, and we brought him back here, all in a matter of 10 minutes.
She's just being silly. What about my cut finger? It's bleeding everywhere.
Oh, stop being such a baby, Edmund. Lucy's just playing a trick on us, aren't you, Lucy? And why shouldn't she?
No, Peter, I'm not making it up. The wardrobe, it's magic, and there's wood inside it, and a lamppost, and a country called Narnia where it's snowing all the time, and I met a faun called Tumnus, and we had tea together. Just look for yourselves! Look!
Okay, come on then, Sue, let's go and see.
Oh, okay.
It's just full of some old fur coats.
No, that can't be true. It's true, I tell you.
Lucy, drop it now. I think you've had enough. It's time to go to bed.
All right, you two. You heard Peter. Edmund, come with me. Let's fix this finger of yours. Lucy, stay here. I'll deal with you in a minute. Come on, Edmund. That's enough.
What can I say? What can I do? How can I make them believe that it all really happened? If I say that I just made it up for fun, they'd believe me and be my friends again. But that would be a real, real lie. It's all so confusing. Perhaps if I get inside the wardrobe and get to Narnia, I could bring something back and prove that I've really been there.
There she goes, talking to herself. She's crazy. Well, I'll follow her into the wardrobe and give her a bit of a fright. Where is she? It's so quiet. Lucy! Lucy, where are you? I know you're in here. What's this on the floor? It's all crunchy like sugar. Ouch, what was that? It's so cold. What on earth? Why?
It's a lamppost! Lucy! Lucy! You were right! The wardrobe is magic! Oh gee, she's mad at me. I'm sorry! Here she goes, sulking somewhere like a girl. Won't even accept an apology.
Stop! And what, pray, are you?
My name is Edmund.
Is that how you address a queen?
I'm sorry, Your Majesty, I didn't know.
He didn't know.
You hear that, Krupskin? Not to know the Queen of Narnia? You shall know us better hereafter. I repeat my question. What are you?
I'm a human.
But you are a human? But you look a little bit like a great overgrown dwarf that is cut off its beard.
Looks mighty strange to me, Grimly.
Nightmarish, if I'd say.
No, Your Majesty, I've never had a beard. I'm a boy.
A boy?
A boy?
A human boy? You are a son of Adam? I see you are an idiot, whatever else you may be. Answer me now. Are you human?
Yes, Your Majesty.
And how, pray, did you come to enter my dominions?
Well, I came in through a wardrobe.
A wardrobe?
A wardrobe?
The boy must be Betsy! Silence! You fools. What do you mean?
Well, I opened a door and just found myself here, Your Majesty.
A door? A door to the world of men. I have heard of such things. This may wreck all, but he is only one, and easily dealt with. Oh, my poor child, how cold you look. Come and sit with me on the sledge. Feeling better, human son?
Yes, Your Majesty.
What lovely fur you have! Something hot to drink?
Yes, please, Your Majesty.
Drink. Drink.
I've never had something like this before. So sweet and foamy and creamy. It warms you down right to your toes.
It is dull, son of Adam, to drink without eating. Food is what you need. How about some Turkish delight?
Looks like candy.
It's better than candy. Eat. Eat.
Tastes like chocolate ice cream with hot fudge sauce.
You're a growing boy. Eat.
Can I have some more?
Do you live all alone in your world, son of Adam?
Oh, no. I've got two sisters and one brother.
Two sons of Adam, two daughters of Eve?
That's four of them.
One of my sisters said she went to Narnia. She said she met a faun.
Do all people in your world know about Narnia?
Oh, no, just me and my sister.
Are you sure there are just four? Two sons of Adam, two daughters of Eve? Are you sure?
I thought I told you that before. Turkish delight, this is amazing candy.
Does your majesty recall the prophecy about the four thrones at Kaer Paravel?
When Adam's flesh and Adam's bone sits at Kaer Paravel enthroned, the evil time be over and done.
No. No. I hate that old prophecy. I have replaced it with a new one of my own. Two kings who shall never be king. Two queens who shall never be queen. Four thrones which lay under a spell shall stay empty always at Kaer Paravel. We have caught one of them, Grumpy. He is falling under my spell. Soon we shall capture all four.
I have never tasted anything so Turkish before. Can I have some more?
I don't have any more. But if you bring your brothers and sisters to visit me at my castle, I will give you all the Turkish delight that you desire.
Oh, well, I don't know.
I would like to make you a prince, and you shall rule over your brothers and sisters. They'll have to do anything you tell them.
Anything. They'd have to do whatever I said.
Yes.
Peter, Susan, and Lucy.
Yes. No Turkish delight for them.
Well, why can't we go to your house now?
It's a wonderful place, my house. Whole rooms filled with Turkish delight.
Oh, rooms full.
Mm-hmm. Oh, rooms.
I have no children of my own. I would like a nice boy whom I can raise as prince. As a prince, he would soon become a king one day when I am gone. And as a prince, he would wear a golden crown and eat Turkish delight all day long. Yes. You, Edmund, are much the handsomest and cleverest young man I have ever met. I would like to make you the prince one day when you bring the others to visit me.
Why not now?
As a king, you will need noble courtiers. I will make your brother a duke and your sisters duchesses.
There's nothing special about them.
Go back to your own country and come with me another day. With them, you understand? It is no good coming without them.
No good.
Don't even think about it.
But I don't know the way home.
I'll show you. There stands the lamp, and there beyond that is the way to the world of men. Now look the other way. Do you see the two hills rising above the trees?
I think so.
That is where my house lies, in between those two hills. And remember, come back with them. I would be very angry if you did not.
Very angry!
I'll try my best.
And don't tell your sister that you met me. That fawn may have told her some nasty stories about me.
Filthy lies!
Nasty stories.
Fawns will say anything, you know. Just bring them towards my house.
Please, please, before I go, could I have one more piece of Turkish delight?
No! You must wait another day. Onwards! Onwards! Till next time, come with them.
Oh,
Edmund!
Lucy!
Oh, Edmund, so you've got it too. Isn't it wonderful? And now?
Yes, yes, you're right. The wardrobe is magic, and I'll say I'm sorry if you'd like, but where have you been? I've looked everywhere for you.
Oh, I've been having lunch with Temis. The White Witch hasn't punished him for letting me go.
The White Witch? Who's she?
Oh, she's terrible.
She calls herself the Queen of Narnia when she doesn't have the right to be queen of anything. All the fauns and dwarves and animals, at least all the good ones, really hate her. She turns people into stone. Oh, and she made a magic over Narnia so that it's always winter. Always winter, but never Christmas.
Who told you all this, Lucy?
Tumnus, the faun.
You can't believe what fauns say.
Who said so?
Ask anyone. Everyone knows that. Listen, Lucy, my feet are cold. Why don't we go back to the professor's house?
Yes, let's. Oh, Edmund, I'm so glad that you got in too. The others are going to have to believe me now.
Yes, yes. Well, there's the wardrobe.
Do you feel ill, Edmund?
No, I'm all right. Just a bit sick.
Must have been something you ate. Come on, let's find the others. There's so much to tell them. We're all going to have great adventures now, all four of us.
Yes, well, let's go.
Edmund?
Lucy, where are you?
Edmund!
Edmund!
Ed!
Lucy, there you are! Peter, Susan, it's all true! Edmund has seen it, the country, and you can get to it through the wardrobe. It's called Narnia. We both saw it. Edmund, go on and tell them about it.
What's this all about, Ed?
Yeah, come on, Edmund, tell us.
Oh, Lucy and I have just been pretending that her whole story about a country in the wardrobe is true. Just for fun, of course. There's nothing really there, believe me.
Edmund, that is a wicked, wicked lie. I don't care what you two say, and I don't care what you two do. I know that I met a faun in Narnia, and I wish I stayed there because you're all horrid.
What's the matter with her? You know, young kids are all the same these days.
What's this really about, Ed?
Nothing, nothing. Lucy's talking utter nonsense.
You know, Lucy was perfectly fine when we first arrived here. And either she's turning into the most horrible liar, or she's going mad. And whichever one it is, Edmund, you'll do her no good by taunting her one minute and encouraging her the next.
Well, I thought... You know, I thought...
You didn't think. You didn't think at all. It's out of sheer spite.
Well, you just stop it. Stop. Okay? Stop. Having a row right now won't make anything better. Besides, it's getting late, and we've been making far too much noise.
Oh, go to blazes, the pair of you! Think just because you're older, you can do whatever you want? Well, I'll show you. I'll really show you.
Now, don't be taking too much time with the professor. He is a very busy man and doesn't need to waste his time with foolish children. Do you understand? I don't like to repeat myself.
Yes, ma'am.
Well then, come along, children. Come along.
Come in, come in. Welcome to my study. I am totally at your disposal.
It's about Lucy, so we think she's ill.
Well, ill in the head at least, or very muddled. You see, Professor, Lucy's been telling us she's entered the wardrobe in the spare room and found herself in some magical country called Narnia.
And she says that she met a faun there and that she had tea with him. We think she's lying, but she swears she's telling the truth.
And this time she's been back to Narnia, and she went with Edmund.
And of course Edmund says it's all a game.
And we all just know you can't walk into a wardrobe and find yourself in some magical country, but whenever we bring it up to Lucy, she gets... so upset, and, well, sir, now we think she hates us.
How do you know that your sister's story isn't true?
Oh, Edmund said they were only pretending.
Well, that is a point which deserves very careful consideration. Now, does your experience lead you to regard your brother or your sister as the more reliable? Which is more truthful?
Well... That's the thing, Professor. Up until now, I would have said Lucy every time.
And I'd agree with Peter, but sir, all this nonsense about teas and fawns and magical countries, it doesn't make sense. It's not logical.
Well, a charge of lying against someone whom you have always found truthful is a very serious thing indeed.
Well then, what if it isn't lying? What if there's something seriously wrong with Lucy?
Madness, you mean? Oh, make your minds easy about that. One only has to look at her and talk to her to see that she's not mad.
But then...
Logic! Why don't they teach logic at these schools? There are only three possibilities. One, your sister is telling lies. Two, she is mad. Or three, she is telling the truth. You know, she doesn't tell lies. And it's obvious that she is not mad. Therefore, we must assume that she is telling the truth.
But, sir, if that were the case, then why doesn't everyone find this magical word in the wardrobe? It wasn't there when we looked.
Mm-mm. What does that have to do with it?
Well, sir, if things are real, then surely they're there all the time.
Are they?
But, sir, Lucy didn't have time to go anywhere. Peter and I were only out in the corridor for 5 minutes, and Lucy claimed she was gone for days.
Ah, but you see, that is the very thing that makes her story so likely to be true. If there really is a door in this house that leads to some other world, I shall not be surprised if that other world has a separate time of its own. And if she really was pretending, she would hide for a reasonable amount of time before popping out to tell her story.
You mean there's just other worlds dotted all over the place, just round the corner like that?
Nothing is more probable. I wonder what they do teach them at these schools.
But, sir, what are we to do about Lucy?
Ah, my dear young lady, there is one plan which no one has yet suggested and is well worth trying.
And what's that?
We all might try minding our own businesses.
Oh.
Farewell, children.
Miss Lucy, I'm showing some people around the mansion today. These are very important art collectors. Will you and the other little monsters hide yourselves away? I'll be very angry if I see any sign of you. I don't like to repeat myself.
We'll be quiet as corpses.
I think I hear the bus is pulling up. Quick, Lucy, find the others. You know what to do.
Peter, Susan, Ed!
They're coming in now!
Oh, Vince!
Hello! We begin our tour under this fine painting by Francis Phelps. A work of pure imagination on the part of the artist. Again, pure imagination on the part of the artist. Now, if you follow me down this long hallway, we'll find some of the most beautiful galleries in the mansion.
Well, there's nowhere else to hide. Back into the old wardrobe. Lucy.
Of course.
What do we do now?
Explore the wood.
You know, it's getting awfully cold. Perhaps we should go back and put on the coats?
Yes.
Thank you.
That's exciting enough without pretending.
Where are we gonna go?
Lucy, why don't you lead the way?
Okay, we'll go this way first. We'll see Tumnus. He's the pawn I
Lucy,
told you about.
Mr. Tumnus's house in the other...
Hang on, Ed. You mean you really were here with Lucy and you've been making her out to be a liar this entire time? Of all the dirty little monsters.
Okay, this way. It's as if somebody's dropped a bomb!
What's happened?
Tumnus's home, it's all destroyed. And this picture of Tumnus's father, it's just all slashed to pieces. I found this notice pinned up.
Let's see.
The former occupant of this premises, the fawn, Tumnus, is under arrest and awaiting trial under regards of high treason against Her Majesty Jadis, Queen of Narnia. And also for fraternizing with her enemies, the humans. Signed Morgrem, Chief of the Secret Police. Long live the Queen.
You know, I don't think I like Narnia very much anymore.
Who is this queen?
She's not a real queen. She's the White Witch. All the wood people really hate her. She made a magic so that it's always winter, but never Christmas. You know, Narnia really doesn't seem like a very friendly place. It's getting colder by the minute, and we don't have anything to eat. I think we should go home. But we can't! Tumnus is in trouble because of me. He hid me from the White Witch and showed me the way home. That's what it means by comforting the Queen's enemies and fraternizing with humans. We've got to rescue him.
We can't do anything.
Oh, shut up, you. What do you think, Susan?
Well, I really don't like Narnia very much, but you know, Lucy is right. Peter, we have to help this fawn.
Yes, I agree. If only we knew where they've taken him.
Look! A robin! That's the first bird that I've seen in Narnia. I wonder if birds could talk in Narnia. Can you show us where they've taken Tumnus? He wants us to follow him. Should we?
Why not?
All right, let's go! Come on!
No, if you're not still high and mighty to talk to me, I've got something which you'd better listen to.
What is it?
How do we know which side this robin is on? Why shouldn't it be leading us into a trap?
Robins are good in all of the stories I've ever read.
This isn't a story, Peter, is it?
Why would a robin be on the wrong side?
Well, if it comes to that, which is the right side? How do we know the robin is good and the queen is bad?
The fawn saved Lucy, Edmund.
He said he did.
The robin's flown away.
So we're lost. What do we do now?
Look! Something moved, right there.
What is it?
I don't know, but look! There it is again!
I see, just behind the willow.
What is that?
I don't know. It's something that doesn't want to be seen.
You know, it could be dangerous. Maybe this is a good time to head back home.
Where's home, Susan?
What is that thing? Look! There it is again! There! Right there!
Are you the sons of Adam and daughters of Eve?
We're some of them.
Not so loud, please. We're not safe even here.
Who are you scared of? There's no one here but us.
Trees have ears. They're always listening. Most of them on our side. But there are trees who betray us to her.
How do we know you're a friend?
Yes, not meaning to be rude, Mr. Beaver, but you see, we're strangers here in Narnia.
Quite right. Quite right. Here's my token.
That handkerchief is poor Tumnus's.
Right. Just before he was arrested, he gave it to me. He said that if anything happened, I must find you and give it to you. You see, Aslan is on the move. Perhaps he's already landed.
Aslan?
What's the matter? Are you all right, children?
Oh, yes. I feel wonderful.
Yes, when you said Aslan, I felt as if it were going to be my birthday forever.
And in mine too, Lucy.
Yes, Aslan makes everyone feel like that.
I think you're all mad.
What about Tumnus?
Shh. Not here. Come back down to my house on the dam for a real talk and some dinner. Here we are. It looks like Mrs. Beaver and the kids were expecting us. Mrs. Beaver, I found them, the sons and daughters of Adam.
They're here.
Oh, these are my children, Bucky and Twig.
How do you do?
Very well, thank you, Bucky and Twig.
Oh, excuse me.
You've come at last. To think I would ever see this day. Care for some sawdust and sticks while you wait for dinner? I'm going to skin these fish and whip up a nice pork salad.
Thank you ever so much, Mrs. Beaver, but I don't think any of us are very hungry.
I don't think any of us really need any food right now. Thank you.
We're all too excited. No need for a big meal.
Well, suit yourselves. There is plenty here if you change your minds.
Thank you. I've never seen a son of Adam or a daughter of Eve before. How do you stay warm in the winter with only hair on your head?
And you can't be very good at chewing wood with those little teeth.
Now, children, you know perfectly well that all animals have their own special gifts. Not everyone can be lucky enough to be born a beaver.
Better get down to business, Mrs. Beaver. It's snowing again. That's good. Anyone following you? Won't find any footprints.
Oh, look, you haven't even touched the sticks. It's fresh maple, not it myself this morning.
What happened to Tumnus?
A very, very bad business. He was taken off by the secret police. I got that from a magpie who saw it done.
But where have they taken him?
They were last seen heading northwards. And we all know what that means.
I'm sorry, Mr. Beaver, but I don't think we do.
It means they were taking him to the witch's house.
Her dad always says, that woman is trouble with a capital T.
Well, whatever that means. But what will they do to him, Mr. Beaver?
He can't exactly say for sure, but her courtyard is full of stone statues. Narnian, she's magicked with her wand. The victim, she's turned into stone.
We've got to do something to help him. This is all because of me.
You go in that witch's house, you'll never come out alive.
We have to do something. Isn't there some strategy we can have? Like, dress up as some... I don't know. This fawn saved Lucy's life. We can't just leave him to be turned into stone, Mr. Beaver.
It's no good, son of Adam. We can't save him alone. But now that Aslan is on the move...
Aslan?
Yes, tell us.
Who's Aslan?
Aslan? Why, you don't know?
He's the king.
Well, he's the lord of the whole wood.
But not often here. You understand.
Never in my time or my father's time. But word has reached us that he has come back. He is in Narnia at this moment. He'll settle the White Witch, all right. It's Aslan, not you, that will save Mr. Tumnus.
Well, won't she turn him into stone too?
Lord love you, son of Adam. What a simple thing to say. Turn Aslan into stone? If she can stand on her 2 feet and look him straight in the face, it'll be the most she can do, and more than I expect of her. No, he'll put it all to rights.
As it says in an old poem in these parts, help me, children.
Wrong will right when Aslan comes in sight. At the sound of his roar, sorrows will be no more.
When he bares his teeth, winter meets its death.
When he shakes his mane, spring again.
He'll understand when you meet him.
Is he a man?
Aslan A man? Certainly not. I tell you, he is the king of the wood and son of the great emperor beyond the sea. Don't you know who the king of beasts is? Aslan is a lion, the lion, the great lion.
A lion? I thought he was a man, you know. I think I'll be rather nervous about meeting a lion.
That you will, dearie. And make no mistake, if there's anyone who can appear before Aslan without their knees knocking, they're either braver than most or else just silly.
Then he isn't safe.
Safe? Don't you hear what Mrs. Beaver tells you? Who said anything about safe? But he's good. He's the king, I tell you.
Well, I'm longing to see him, even if I am frightened.
That's right, son of Adam, and you shall. Word has reached us. You are to meet Aslan at the stone table.
Where is the stone table?
Down the river, a good step from here. I'll take you.
But what about Tumnus?
Quickest way to help him is by going to meet Aslan. Once we're with him, we can begin doing things. Things must be drawing near their end now that you four have come and he's come.
Why?
There's an old castle on the seacoast called Caer Paravel. And there's an old prophecy that says, when two sons of Adam and two daughters of Eve...
That's you guys!
When two sons of Adam and two daughters of Eve sit at the thrones at Caer Paravel, the White Witch's reign will be over.
If she knew about you four, your lives wouldn't be worth a shake of my whiskers.
Hey, I think we're missing your brother.
Where's Edmund?
Edmund?
How long has he been gone?
Who saw him last?
Children, did you see him leave?
No, Mother.
Edmund?
Edmund?
Edmund!
Oh, Edmund!
Edmund? Edmund? Peter, this is terrible. See, I told you something would go wrong. We should never have come here. Edmund?
Edmund?
What are we going to do, Mr. Beaver?
Do? We must be off at once. We haven't a moment to spare.
Oh, but Mr. Beaver, he could still be around. We have to find him.
We have to split into four search parties, all go in different directions. The first one to find here, come back here at once and...
No point in looking for him.
But we have to. He's our brother, even if he is a little monster.
You can't go to the witch's house. Your only chance of saving him is to keep well clear of her.
How do you mean?
As long as Edmund's the only one she's got, she'll keep him alive as bait to catch the rest of you.
But can't anybody help us?
Only Aslan. We'll go and meet him. He's our only chance.
Can we come with you?
Please?
We promise we'll be ever so good.
Of course you can come. It wouldn't be safe here. Just when did your brother slip away? How much he can tell the witch depends on how much he heard. Had we started talking of Aslan before he left?
I don't know.
He was still here. He asked if the witch could turn Aslan to stone.
Yes, right. That's right.
Worse and worse. He was still here when I told you we were to meet Aslan at the stone table?
I don't know.
I never saw him go. He must have crept out. I don't know when.
The moment Edmund tells her we're here, she'll set out to catch us. So she'll be here in about 20 minutes.
You're right, Mrs. Beaver. We must get away. We haven't a moment to lose.
Season's greetings, everyone! I've managed to get here at last. Thanks to Aslan.
Hello!
Oh, and my hardworking team of elves. Let me introduce you to Rufus and Butterfingers.
Nice to meet you, folks.
Good to be able to get our sled moving again. A merry, merry to all of you.
Yes, the wicked witch, Jadis, has kept me away too long. But with Aslan on the move, her magic is wakening. And now, you may all have your Christmas presents!
I'll get the bag!
Line up, folks!
Me first! No, I'm first, Bucky! I'm the oldest!
Well, I have a bigger tail than you, so there!
No arguing! Children, you will have your presents soon enough!
I hope it's birch bark!
Never chewed birch bark before!
Close your eyes, you two!
Here you go.
I knew it.
What do you say to Father Christmas, girls?
Thank you very much, sir.
Yes, thank you.
And there's something for you, Miss Beaver.
Why, thank you, Father Christmas.
And here's a gift certificate for Mr. Beaver. The bearer of this certificate will find his old dam, will have all its leaks stopped, and a brand new sluice gate fitted for the spring.
You can thank Butterfingers for that one, sir. He'll be back around to your dam after we're done with our Christmas rounds.
A new sluice gate. Just think, Mrs. Beaver. Thank you all.
Peter.
Go on, Peter, go.
Son of Adam. Your presents are no longer toys. Bear them well.
Oh, thank you, Santa.
Susan. This is for you. When you blow the horn, wherever you are, help will come to you.
Thank you ever so much.
Lucy, if any of your friends are ever hurt, the juice of fire flower from the mountains of the sun will restore them to health again. Use the dagger only in times of great need.
Thank you so much, Father Christmas.
And now, I must be on my way. I have so much to catch up on. Merry Christmas, everyone!
Merry Christmas!
Dashing through the
snow in a one-horse open sleigh, over fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight.
And now, we must be moving off to the stone table.
Come on, my dearies. It's a long way to go, and she won't be far behind.
My name is Edmund, and I'm the son of Adam. Her Majesty met me in the woods the other day, and I've come to bring her the news that my brothers and sisters are now in Narnia!
I am Margaret, Chief of the Queen's Secret Police, and I enjoy my work very much.
Will you tell your Majesty I've come?
I will tell her. Meanwhile, stay here, as you value your life!
I wonder what the witch, I mean, the queen, I wonder what she'll do to the others. I don't really want them turned into stone statues, but I badly need some Turkish delight, and I want to be a prince!
You are privileged, son of Adam. Come now, fortunate favorite of the Queen, or else not so fortunate, the Queen of Narnia!
Tell you to bring the other three along with you?
Answer the great query!
I've done my best. They're at Mr. and Mrs. Beaver's house.
Is that all your news, son of Adam?
No, the Beaver says Aslan is on the move.
Aslan?
They say they're going to meet him at the stone table.
Aslan? Aslan. If I find that you have lied to me...
No, Your Majesty, that's what the Beaver said.
We must make ready for a journey.
Everything's prepared, Your Majesty.
Please, Your Majesty, I haven't had anything to eat for lunch. Could I have some torch to light?
Silence, you fool! Bring the human creature food and drink. It will not do to have the little brat fainting on the way for lack of food.
Majesty's wisdom is exceeded only by her beauty.
Very true, Margrim.
Turkish light!
Turkish light!
Turkish light!
That's just stale bread and mucky water.
Eat and drink.
Yeah, sorry.
You should get used to prisoner food. I should leave the green bits.
Margrim, remember your mistress's prophecy?
Two kings who shall never be king. Two queens who shall never be queen. Four thrones which lay under a spell will stay empty always at Caer Paravel.
Here is the plan, Margrim. Take your swiftest of wolves and go to the Beaver's house. Kill whatever you find there. Then make haste to the stone table and wait for me there.
I hear and obey, O Queen.
What are you doing?
Summoning his fellow wolves, fool. Go prepare the harness and the sledge, and please use the harness without the bell.
Harness without the bells?
Harness without bells!
Harness without bells!
Harness without bells!
Harness without bells! Harness without bells!
Spring is surely here, Mrs. Beaver. Isn't it lovely?
Look there! It's a beautiful bluebird.
Why, that's a kingfisher twig.
And there are some blue, beautiful flowers.
Oh, I know those. Those are called bluebells.
Just listen to those glorious sounds. I've been looking at books and dreaming about spring all these years, and I never imagined anything quite so splendid.
Ooh, feel the wind in your fur. What was that? It's past my nose.
It's a bee.
Good gracious me, a bee? I haven't seen a bee in years and years and years.
Never seen a bee, my dear. Only read about them in books.
True, Mrs. Beaver. Very true.
All the flowers and trees are going ever so quickly. Look, Lucy, can't you see?
I expect you would, too, if you had a sudden shower of fresh water to wake you up from a very long, sleepy winter.
With some lovely spring sunshine to warm you up and dry off your fur. What does the great poet say now?
Wet fur, warm sun, dry fur, great fun, to Father Christmas and Aslan.
Look, we have company.
Greetings, travelers. Will you stop by and have some plum pudding? Or just a wee nip of hot cider?
Mother, can we try some cider, please?
Thank you, but we can't stop for anything.
Do you know if we're nearing the stone table in Aslan's camp?
Yes, it's just over the hill.
Oh, thank you ever so much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
It's you, so queen. We can't pull a sled in all this mud.
You fools are utterly useless. Stop! What is the meaning of this? What have we here? Speak, vermin.
would you like my dwarves to help you find the words?
Do you want me to find your tongue with my whip?
Oh. What is the meaning of all this gluttony? This waste, this self-indulgence? Where did you get all of these things?
Please, Your Majesty, we were given them. If I were to be so bold as to drink from Your Majesty's gift...
Who gave them to you?
Who?
Father Christmas.
Impossible.
Christmas?
He cannot have been here. No. Say you are lying, and you shall even now be forgiven.
Oh, don't, please, don't!
As for you, let this teach you to ask favor for spies and traitors!
Mind your own business, fool!
This is Aslan's doing!
If either of you fools say that name again, you shall be instantly killed! Onwards! Onwards! Quickly! Come
Well, go on.
Oh, you first.
Sons of Adam before animals.
We have come, Aslan.
Welcome, Peter, son of Adam. Welcome, Susan and Lucy, daughters of Eve. Welcome, the beaver and she-beaver. But where's the fourth?
He has tried to betray them and join the White Witch, O Aslan.
That was partially my fault, Aslan. I got mad at with him, and I think that's what led him to do wrong.
Please, Aslan, can't anything be done to save Edmund?
All shall be done, but it may be harder than you think. Meanwhile, let the feast be prepared. Come, Peter, and I will show you a far sight of where you are to be king. Come. That, O man, as Cair Paravel the four thrones, one of which you must sit as king. I show this to you because you are the eldest and will sit as high king over all the rest.
That was Susan blowing the ivory horn.
Your sister's in danger.
Danger?
Lucy? Lucy! Lucy, run! Lucy! Lucy! Come on! Quickly! Quickly!
Back! Back! Let the prince win his spurs. Another wolf in the thicket. After him, all of them. He'll be scampering back to his mistress. Follow him. Find the witch and bring back the fourth son of Adam. You have forgotten to clean your sword. Come. Peter, kneel. Your sword. Arise, Sir Peter Wolfsbane! And never forget to clean your sword.
no use, Queen. They must have reached the stone table by now. We've got this one. Let's bargain for him.
Yes, and let them rescue him.
Well, then we better do what we gotta do at once.
I would like to have it done on the stone table. That is where it's always been done.
Spare me, Your Majesty. Let me go home.
Home? You have no home.
Captain Malgrim approaches Your Majesty with news of the humans.
We have seen them, Your Majesty.
Who? Who have you seen?
The son of Adam and the daughters of Eve.
They are no match for my powers.
Aslan is with them.
And they killed my best lieutenant. A son of Adam killed my soldier. With Aslan helping them, we must retreat.
Fly?
Fly!
Fly!
Fly! Fly!
Fly!
Fly! There will be no flogging!
Be off, quickly. Go and summon all those creatures who are still on my side. Call out to the werewolves and the ghouls and those spirits of the trees that are on my side. We will fight! Be off, quickly. I have a little business to finish here in private. Prepare the victim!
Prepare the victim! Prepare the victim! Prepare the victim! Prepare the victim! I'll never come back to Narnia, I promise!
No. 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 No, please, no!
They are gone.
What are we gonna do now, oh queen?
I must make ready for a journey. Come with me.
A journey? A journey?
Sir Peter, Susan, Lucy, and the beavers. Here's your brother, and there's no need to talk with him about what is past.
I'm sorry, Peter. I'm sorry, Susan.
It's all right.
I'm sorry, Lucy.
It's okay.
Sire, messengers from the enemy, crave audience.
Let them approach. What is your message, son of Earth?
The Queen of Narnia and the Empress of the Lone Isles desires a safe conduct to come and speak with you. It is a matter which is much to your importance as to hers.
Queen of Narnia, indeed, of all the chiefs!
Beaver, all names shall be restored to their proper owners. Let your mistress know that I will grant her safe conduct if she leave her wand behind her at the Great Oak.
The Great Oak, okay, okay.
The Great Oak, that is agreed.
Suppose she turns the leopards into stone.
They'll be all right. Trust Aslan.
Here she comes now, large as life and twice as ugly.
You have a traitor there,
Aslan. His offense was not against you.
Have you forgotten the deep magic?
Let us say I have. Tell us of this deep magic.
Surely you know of the deep magic that is written on this stone table that stands behind us. And surely you know of the deep magic that the Emperor put on Narnia at the very beginning. Every traitor belongs to me.
Every treachery ends in blood. His life is forfeit to me. His blood, my property. And you know that if I do not have these things as I desire, all of Narnia will be overturned and perish in fire and water.
It is true. I do not deny it.
Please, Aslan, there must be something we can do about this deep magic.
Go against the Emperor's magic? Fall back, all of you. And I will talk to the witch alone.
Oh, Edmund.
Don't cry, Lucy.
Don't worry, Aslan will do whatever can be done.
Even Aslan can't go against the deep magic.
Exactly. We'll protect you, Edmund. He won't get to you.
Mm. We'll make sure you're okay.
Trust Aslan, okay?
Just
you can all come back. I have settled the matter. She has renounced the claim on your brother's blood.
Oh, my God. Oh, Edmund. How do I know that your promise will be kept?
There's work to be done. You must move from this place at once for what we wanted for other purposes. We can camp down there, at the fords of Baruna.
Peter, what do you think Aslan's arranged to do with the witch?
I don't know, but he looks very stern.
Come, Peter. A battle will begin soon. Listen carefully. Once the witch is finished with her business with me, at the stone table, she and her troops will fall back to her castle and prepare for a siege. You may be able to cut off here in the wood. Position some of your fighters below the wood so they can charge her when she is chased out of the wood.
I see.
On the other hand, if you have to assault her castle, surround it at a distance, moving gradually. Wait and watch until you find her weak point.
You will be there yourself, Aslan.
I can give you no promise of that.
But what if they attack tonight down at the forts of Baruna?
No! She will not attack tonight. Anyways, that is how a soldier ought to think. But that is beyond our matter. Come, let us join the others at the fords and take our supper together.
Susan?
What?
I've got this feeling as if something's hanging over us.
Me too.
It's about Aslan. Something terrible is gonna happen to him. Or he's gonna do something terrible.
You know, he was acting very strange ever since we left the witch yesterday. And what did he say about leaving us at the final battle? Do you think he'll slip away and leave us tonight?
Where is he? I looked all around the camp for him, and I couldn't find him.
I don't know.
Aslan.
Oh, children. Children.
Please, Aslan, may we stay with you? Why have you left the camp?
Well, I should be glad of the company for a little while. Yes, you may stay, but only if you promise to leave when I tell you to.
Yes, thank you.
Aslan, are you ill?
No. I am sad and lonely. Help me walk. Children! Children! They're here sooner than I expected. Oh, there's no way for you to get past them. Hide as best as you can. Do not let yourselves be seen. Farewell!
royal
beast!
The fool has come.
Sacrificing your life to save his, that everything would be all right? Now, when you are gone, who will save them? You, I will kill you, and the magic will be satisfied in that way. Did you really think that by sacrificing yourself to save him, that everything would be saved? Narnia is now mine, and there's nothing you can do about it. In that knowledge, despair and die! Despair and die!
Cold and stuffy. Just too much.
We have to go tell the others. We have to go let Peter know and the others and... Why, Lucy, look! I can see a great castle on a cliff overlooking the sea. Why, that must be Caer Paravel.
You're right.
What was that?
I don't know. I'm too scared to look.
All right, well, on the count of three, then.
Okay.
One, two, three.
Oh. Aslan.
I can't believe my eyes. It's a miracle.
Is it more magic?
Yes, it is more magic.
Aslan, what does this mean?
It means that although the witch knew the deep magic well enough, her knowledge only goes back as far as the dawn of time. If she could have looked back a little bit further into the stillness and darkness of before time began, she would have known of another incantation, another spell that states when a willing victim dies in the place of a traitor, that the stone table would crack and death itself would be reversed.
And all of this means, Aslan, you're alive?
You're really, really alive?
Yes, yes, it does.
Not a ghost?
Boo! Don't worry, I'm just joking about. I'm not dead. Oh, children, this is so exciting. I feel my strength coming back in leaps and bounds! Oh, yes, this is wonderful! But children, we ought to get to business. I feel as if I'm going to roar. You had better cover your ears. Now, we must make our way to the witch's house quickly, and then to help your brothers in battle. Let's go!
Bless me, I must have been asleep. Now where's that dry little witch going off to? Somewhere just by my feet it was.
She's not here.
Well, where is she then? I got a word or two to say with her.
Don't worry about the witch. We'll find her.
Aslan, the true and great. I beg your pardon, sir. Please, please allow me to.
Oh my! Oh my, oh my, oh my, oh my! Oh my goodness, Henley!
Oh. Now what is your name?
Rumblebuffin, sir, if you please, Your Honor.
Oh, what a pleasant and polite lion.
Oh, yes. The Buffins always were a respected family in Narnia. Not very clever or scary, but very kindly creatures. If they were the ferocious type, he wouldn't have been turned to stone by the White Witch. Oh, Lucy.
Now, our day's work isn't over yet. If we are to finally defeat the witch, we must find the battlefield at once and now. Those who are not able to keep up, such as all dwarves, animals, and children, ride on the backs of those who can. Lions, centaurs, giants, horses, and eagles. And those who are good with their noses, join us lions at the front so we can sniff out where the battlefield is. Look lively and sort yourselves out.
Whoa, 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 wait. Did you hear that? He said us lions. That means him and me. Us lions. See, that's what I like about Aslan. Best guy I've ever met. Us lions.
Are you ready?
Yes!
Then follow me!
Yourself.
You have no chance. You have no magic.
We have Aslan. That's magic enough.
Aslan is dead! Foolish son of Adam!
Allow me! My queen, allow me! Come, Aslan!
You fool!
Die, Aslan!
You have done well. It was all Edmund's doing, Aslan. That witch was turning our people into stone left and right. Edmund spotted her and fought his way through three ogres to get to her. But then the wolf got to him first. Where is he?
Here's the poor lamb.
Oh, Edmund. Oh, no. I'm sorry, Edmund.
Did we win?
Of course we did. It was a hard-fought battle, though.
Aslan! Oh, how wonderful to see you. There were so few left of us at the end there. I thought we must have lost.
It was all thanks to Aslan. The witch is dead. The battlefield is ours!
Woo!
And Lucy... And Susan?
They are safe and well.
Thanks to Aslan.
No. And all thanks to you. Peter, your sword. Come, Edmund, kneel. There is no greater honor than to be knighted on the field of battle. Arise, Sir Edmund Wandbreaker! Long
live King Peter! Long live Queen Susan! Long live Queen Lucy! Long live King Edmund!
Once a king or queen in Narnia, always a king or queen of Narnia. Farewell, Sons of Athens. Farewell, Sons of Thebes. My people of Narnia, we have won a fabulous victory here together today. And I would love to stay and celebrate it with you, but I have other countries to visit, evils to fight. And so, someone else must rule in my stead. And as the prophecy states, we all know who that must be. When Adam's flesh and Adam's bone sit at Caer Paravel on the throne, the evil time will be o'er and done. Here we have two sons of Adam and two daughters of Eve, who can wield the fourth throne for all to pursue. Sir Peter Wolfsbane. I name you King Peter the Magnificent. Tell us, how will you rule Narnia?
I will seek out all evil and destroy it.
Susan. I name you Queen Susan the Just. Tell us how you rule Narnia.
I will seek out ways of keeping the peace.
Sir Edmund Wandbreaker.
I name you King Edmund the Courageous.
Tell us how you will rule Narnia.
I will make good laws so that Narnia may live and sleep safely.
Lucy. Oh.
I name you Queen Lucy the Valiant.
Tell us how you will rule Narnia.
Well, I'll stop the good trees from being cut down, and I'll stop young dwarfs and satyrs who being sent to school too early, and I'll rebuild the Mrs. home, and I'll stop busybodies.
It is well. It is very well. My people of Narnia, I leave you in the safe hands of your new kings and queens. Oh, the beavers!
Sorry, dearie. He'll often drop in. Only you must impress him.
We'll be coming and going, you know. One day you see him, and the next he won't. This is like being tied down.
No.
And of course, CSI countries to attend to. It's quite all right. He'll often drop in.
Long live King Peter! Long live Queen Susan! Long live Queen Lucy! Long live King Edmund! Long live King Peter! Long live Queen Susan! Long live Queen Lucy! Long live King Edmund!
this lamp works upon me strangely, as I've seen it before in a dream, or a dream of a dream.
And on mine too.
And for me also. For I feel as if we pass by this lamp, we shall either encounter a strange new adventure or a drastic change in our fortunes.
And in mine too.
We four, queens and kings of Narnia, have never set ourselves to any higher matter, as battles, quests, and the like, and then abandoned them.
Then in the name of Aslan, let us go forth. Let us take the adventures that shall fall to us.
You are right, Queen Susan. Allow me to take the lead.
Branches.
Look, a thicket of coats.
Whatever the obstacle, we must push through.
Through the coats.
Look, and beyond.
I see light. Move forward.
Oh. So there you are, you wretched children. I've been looking for you everywhere. Don't you know that playing in wardrobes is dangerous?
It's all right, Mrs. MacReady. Thank you for finding them. Now, children, have you solved that little problem with Edmund and Lucy?
Yes, sir. Lucy was absolutely right.
And I was absolutely wrong. And I'm sorry, everyone.
Professor, I'm afraid we've lost four of your fur coats.
Lost them? Well, you see, we went into the wardrobe and we got to Narnia. Oh, and it was so cold that we had to put on fur coats. Oh, and then we met Mr. Beaver and Mrs. Beaver. Oh, and poor Tumnus was turned into stone and captured by the White Witch. Oh, and then we met Aslan the Great Lion. And there was a great battle with the wicked White Witch, who looked just like...
Mrs. MacReady, I think you can go now.
Professor, would you like us to maybe go back in the wardrobe and get the coats?
Oh, no. I don't think it will be any use to go back into Narnia that way again.
Is there any other way?
Oh, yes. There's another way. Someday. But don't try and use the same route twice. Indeed, don't try and get there at all. It will come when you least expect it.
But, sir, how do we know?
Oh, you'll know. Odd things they say, the look in their eyes. You can always tell. What do they teach you at these schools?
<Yeah. laughs>